Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's see how to create 3D objects and apply 3D effects with CorelDRAW X8. Leave us comments in video description to improve our future videos dedicated to CorelDRAW. You can create 3D objects from 2D shapes by using the Extrude tool on the left. Select the 2D object to extrude, enable the Extrude tool, and then click and drag on the shape. This will create a 3D extrusion with a defined direction and depth. This tool can be used to create 3D text as well, but does not work with images. Check out our video to know how to make 3D text with CorelDRAW. You can edit the 3D extrusion as you like. Click and drag the black cross to change its direction and move the small rectangle on the dashed line to regulate the extrusion depth. Also, if you click once on the object, you can click and drag outside to rotate around the dashed line or click and drag within the dashed circle to rotate completely freely. Click once again to finish with the 3D rotation. Pay attention that the 3D rotation also fixes the position of the cross. When you see the cross in white color, you won't be able to move it anymore. More above, on the property bar, you can use presets to select a ready preset for the extrusion applied, extrusion type to change the way to apply the effect, adjust the X and the Y coordinates to regulate the extrusion direction or cross placement, depth to adjust the extrusion depth, and extrude rotation to apply a precise 3D rotation. This shows a pixelated 3 that you can click and drag to apply a 3D rotation. Then use the reset button to undo all, or the right button to regulate rotation respect of each of the three axes. Also, this 3D rotation fixes the cross point, as you can see from its color. To remove the 3D extrusion definitely, just click on the Clear Extrusion button. Let's see how to edit the appearance of this 3D object. When you apply 3D extrusion on a 2D shape with no filling, you will get an extrusion that is completely transparent. To add basic filling, you can go to the Object Properties panel on the extreme right and go to the Fill tab. Choose between a solid color, a gradient, or a pattern. This will be applied to the basic 2D shape, and so to the 3D extrusion applied on it. The properties bar above has several advanced tools to edit your extrusion. For example, Extrusion Bevels allows you to add bevels and regulate their inclination and depth. Extrusion Lighting regulates the light sources applied on the 3D shape. By default, you have two light sources enabled in different positions. You can enable or disable light sources by using the buttons on the left and change their respective position by clicking and moving them through the 3D grid shown. Then regulate the intensity of the selected light source through the intensity bar at the bottom. Also, you can regulate the extrusion appearance by using Extrusion Color. Here you have three solutions. Enable the first button to use as extrusion color, the same color of the 2D shape, defined on the Object Properties panel, seen before, while the bevels will get the color defined under Bevel Color, more below. Enable Use Solid Color to apply an independent color, and Use Color Shading to add a two-color gradient on the extruded part. The 2D shape can show a 2D outline. If this does not fit the 3D extrusion, you can disable it by going to the Object Properties panel and choosing No Color as Outline. In case you want to edit the 3D extrusion again, remember to enable the Extrude tool and click on the interested shape. You can also apply 2D effects on the objects extruded. These affect the basic 2D object. If this changes, also its extrusion follows, adapting to the new shape obtained. Other effects, such as the shadow effect, can't be applied on the extruded shape directly. In this case, you have to group the shape and its extrusion together first. Enable the Pick tool and click and drag on the shape and its extrusion to select both. Then, right-click and go to Group Objects. At this point, the Drop Shadow tool will work without problems. You can also apply an amazing 3D effect called Perspective by going to the Effects tab and then to Add Perspective. This changes the general perspective of the object by changing the shape of the grid. Also, you can apply 3D effects to your imported pictures, all collected inside the Bitmaps tab under 3D effects. Check them. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides on the most important software.